sportbets.com. Уникальное место для настоящего геймера. Только здесь возможны ставки на киберспортивные события. Ты знаешь толк в самых популярных играх и готов рисковать? Смотри регулярные трансляции и зарабатывай реальные деньги. eSportBets.com. Живой азарт и холодный расчет.
And with that, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the stream. This is Room on Fire. I'm Anders, and we have the SLTV Starseries Season 10 game coming up between Fnatic and Epsilon. It's going to be a really fun game right here on Mirage, and we have a pretty cool evening ahead of us. After this game, we still have virtus.pro and Fnatic. Then we have maybe a bit of an odd game in virtus.pro versus USSR, but then it goes right back to virtus.pro Epsilon, and then Epsilon versus Reason. So 4 out of 5 ain't bad for an evening, and that's going to be 5 or 6 hours of Counter-Strike coming up for you guys right here on the channel. So hope you're going to enjoy yourselves. I am going to be alone for this first game because, Semler is out and about. Normally we don't cast on Fridays because normally there aren't actually any games on Friday, but this time there was, and Semler already had a plan that was fair enough, so we let him go. Vendetta's with some family as well, so I'm going to be alone for the first game, but after that, Hiko is going to be joining me, and it's going to be great fun, and he'll be here, I think, for the last 4 games. So, definitely really cool. Hiko is such a great guy, and I'm really happy he wants to help me out, because solo casting for 5 hours is, or 6 hours, is going to be pretty rough. So, the first game I'll be alright with, but don't worry, this game hasn't started yet. They're just waiting to warm up. Everyone has connected, so we should be good to go. Now, I have a bit of a plan this evening. I hope you guys are going to join me in on it, because I think this is going to be good fun. What I want to do, because we don't really have the funds to pay collar casters just yet. I hope in the future we'll be able to, because when people come on the channel and help us out, we want to give them something in return, but we can't quite do it yet. So for now, what we can do to try and pay Hiko back is get him some followers on Twitter, because that does matter at the end of the day, especially because Hiko's streaming so much. I think actually Hiko was just streaming in front of almost 8,000 viewers, so he's done a really great job, and you gotta appreciate how much that helps the community. It really does make a big difference when individual pro players decide to stream like Hiko does, because, you know, it gets more people into the game and it grows the scene a lot, so definitely do that. But yeah, follow him on Twitter. I want to see if we can get Hiko 1,000 more followers. He's at 9,000 right now. So if we can get him to 1,000, actually he's at 9,100. So if we can get him 900 more followers tonight, I think he's going to be pretty excited about that. So don't forget to do it. I'll remind you during the evening. That's the goal for the evening, getting Hiko another 900 followers. I think we can definitely do that. He deserves it as well. But this game, guys, is going to be Epsilon versus Fnatic. Best of one game, of course, will be on Mirage. And I don't know, this game on CSGO Lounge has had, I think, 55% in favor of Fnatic and 45% in favor of Epsilon. And that seems pretty reasonable to me. I think whenever you're dealing with sort of the top contenders in Global Offensive, in a best of one game, at least, online, it's pretty hard to say that it's going to be more than sort of a 50-50 game, unless you're really feeling brave. But generally, say 50-50 is right about where it's at. I don't know. Epsilon have been, you know, upsetting and surprising a lot of teams lately. FXGO, the latest addition, replacing Mistu, has turned out to be a really good addition. He's been incredible so far. But you gotta wonder if he's gonna have a bad game, you know. And if he does, who's gonna step it up? Maybe Shoxi? Maybe not. You really don't know. And Fnatic, on the other hand, well, they have a new lineup too. It's Crims and Olofmeister replacing Schneider and Jada on Devilwalk. And that's been looking actually pretty good too. So, 2 new lineups, 2 really great teams in a best of one game. Don't think you can get much better than this. Remember as well to follow and subscribe to the channel and all of that, and we'll see how this game unfolds. Again, remember, I am solo casting, so maybe there's going to be some pauses when I'm just thinking about things, or we'll see how it all goes. I'm going to try and look a little bit more in the chat as well, because that can be important. So once we put subscriber mode on, which we probably will, around 15,000 viewers, that's usually how I rule, 15,000 viewers, then we put sub mode on, because, you know, subscribers get a little bit of a chance to chat, and everyone else gets a chance to not get spammed to death, so there are some advantages all around. This knife round looks like it's going to be Flusher about to get stabbed here. Knife round, not the most important thing, I think, on this map, so wouldn't take it too seriously. But obviously, Epsilon, they get to stay on the CT side, which is the more favored side on this map. But not, I would say, a big impact on this game just yet. All right, so welcome to the stream. Hope you guys are going to enjoy the evening. We have five great games coming up for you, and this is the SLTV Starseries Season 10. I'm Anders, and this is Room on Fire. Welcome, and thank you for joining us, and we'll see how this is going to unfold. We start off with Kyushima and Shoxi making their way to the A-bomb site. They have FXO in the middle. Exact same setup that they had last time they played this map, so no real difference. And they did win on Mirage, so I don't really blame them for keeping the same one. I like the addition of the Molotov over here on DMX. He's SF spotting, and then probably time for DMX to throw it out, so this is looking pretty good. Fnatic, on the other hand, they definitely have a bit of a push going on towards the middle if they can just execute it. They're leaving the bomb behind, so they're not going to go for a bomb site immediately. They just want to try and see if they can get a pick off on somebody. In turn, actually, it's Superfighter to pick off JW over by the B bomb site, and I don't know. I could see what Fnatic wanted to do here. Olofmeister by A, and then JW by B, and everyone else in the middle looking for pickoffs, but it didn't work out that way. GMX is going to spot one more person. That's a big tell now for Epsilon. The fact that they just saw a person there gives them something to work with. And it seems like they've actually switched up. They really wanted to go for the B bomb site, but now they've changed and they're looking for yet another pickoff. And I think this is cool. This is a good idea for Fnatic. The only thing that's a problem now is the time that's working against them. 30 seconds is very, very short to get something happening. It will be an A push now. We can definitely see that. Shoxi's here with the P2000. He's very good at using it, but he's going to get flashed, so that's pretty hard now. Kyushima down here towards Shadows already used a lot of bullets, and he's actually going to go down. Shoxi should just try and wait for backup and make sure he doesn't get overrun. He's going to pick up a great headshot there. Goes for a second one. Crims dropping low, and Shoxi will take him down. Still no bomb plan, and with only 8 seconds left, it's just not going to be working out. Shoxi with the double, and then SF with a double, and that is the end of the first round here. Epsilon picking it up, not without any issue. That could have been a different round, but Fnatic left themselves very little time to actually work with, and that's a problem. And again, just to point out, someone was asking in chat here, I won't be solo casting all night, guys. Hiko is going to be joining me from Complexity. He's going to be joining me after this game. So it's only the first game, and it's kind of nice. I think the most I've ever solo casted was about 6 or 7 hours, but I'm glad I'm not doing that so much anymore, because that is pretty stressful. Some good shooting through the smoke coming out here from Superfighter. Even has time to reload, and we'll pick up another couple of kills. Actually, Pronax is going to take down GMX, but I don't think he put the bomb down here. The Swedish in-game leader here not going to make it work. And FXO comes in with a kill just in the meantime. Superfighter with now 5-1-0, so not at all bad. Where is Semler? Prine is asking. Well, he is he's out with, I think, some family and friends. He already had made a plan, and normally, guys, we don't have any games on Friday. SLTV normally don't schedule games on Friday, and almost no other tournament does either, unless it's LAN. So we kind of keep Friday and Saturday, you know, open for all sorts of other stuff, and we found out a little bit late that this was happening, so Semler said he could come if I was going to make him, but I said, don't do it. Like, it's really important to spend some time with family, and we don't always have a lot of time, so I just told him it's cool, do it. Oh, that's a great headshot coming out. Superfighter already down to 17 HP, and this could actually be the beginning of something pretty cool for Fnatic. There's JW taking down a player, and well, we'll see. Superfighter really didn't stand much of a chance. The bomb is going to go down as well, and let's see if this is actually going to slip out of control for Epsilon. They should be able to retake this. Kyushima with a good shot. Shoxi comes in with one flusher, trying with the P250, but not going to connect with that bullet, and that means JW's alone and pretty far away from the action, so I managed to hype that up maybe a little bit too much. Sad that that they couldn't make it, but it's like really good stuff. And they do get the kill on SF, so it's not all bad. JW, exit kill maybe? No, he's not going to get anything for it, but they have a lot of money going into the fourth round. Fnatic didn't manage to plant any bombs in the first two rounds, which means they're about $1,600 short. That's why they waited until this fourth round where they can buy. And they had enough money to buy an AWP and pretty much everyone, but they've gone with all AKs. And interestingly, FXO has done the same, which he did the last couple of times when they were on the CT side. Just started off with no AWP until things, you know, started to fall apart for them, and then he picked it up. To pretty good success as well. Missed shot there. Pronax ready and waiting. Takes down SF. Now GMX is going to be the next target, and he has to stand his ground here. The bomb is making its way, and they need to make a rotation, Epsilon, which right now they're not. So a little bit sloppy play coming out here from the Frenchman, and that can cost them a lot. Being shot through the smoke, GMX is now down to 22, but he is going to look for a kill, and JW somehow miraculously survives. FXO coming up from behind. He's going to take down Flusher, but this is going to be a very tough retake, I think, for the French. Pronax gets another kill. That's a double for him. And at this point, I'm not sure if they should keep going for it. They do have actually no money on SF. So everyone else can buy. Maybe it's worth it. I'm not sure. I feel like so much time has passed already. Krim's ducking that bullet, and FXJ will go down, same as Kiyoshima. A great quad kill from Pronax that round, and Fnatic make it 3-1. And they are going to be able to buy on Epsilon side. They'll just have to drop one for SF, which they can, and there's FXJ and an auto sniper. Look at this, guys. Definitely a big switch up right here. Auto sniper and AWP. And Fnatic still without one, but if they get opening frags like that, there's really no reason they should have an AWP at this point. JW, is he going to try the exact same thing he really wants to? Going to walk right in and take down DMX, and that, unfortunately, is a little bit sloppy play from DMX. When you have an auto sniper in that position, you should be able to win it. And if you're not there in time, all you have to do is smoke up like they just did. The smoke that that FXJ just threw up there, they could have just thrown that to begin with, and they would have been in a great position. Now Kiyoshima and also Shox here in a really awkward position. If they can rotate up and get the bomb down here, that's going to change things. But they already made noise. I think Fnatic know they're going to be peeking right here. Shoxi looking the wrong way, goes down. Kiyoshima next in line, going to spray down one and two and get the bomb. But that might not even be enough. They're all coming for him one at a time here. And SF is going to be alone in a one-on-three. So not exactly the ideal start here for Epsilon. I mean, winning the pistol round is good and all, but they've been making some strange mistakes afterward. This round isn't over yet. Superfighter's still going to come and see if he can take down Pronox and Olofmeister both. The bomb is going to go down, and it's right in front of him, but he couldn't stop it. Question is if he can defuse it. It's going to be really tough. Olofmeister with a good position. Pronox with almost an even bet. Actually, this is like the ideal position, though. SF does get the kill. And now, is he going to realize? All Pronox has to do is stand up and take a headshot. It'll be easy, I think. SF looking for him. He's just checking everywhere. And Pronox doing a great job of dodging. And SF actually decides it's not even worth it. And that might be the right call at this point. He has 4,450 value on him. And there's almost 100% chance he would have lost that one-on-one. But now, is he going to go down anyway? Pronox is coming so close. The round is not over yet. Oh, God. He survives with just 10 HP. And that is it. 3-2. But now Epsilon should be ecoing. So there we go. Again, now that I see a lot more people have joined, thank you for tuning in. I'm only going to be solo casting this first game, guys. After that, we get Hiko joining us, and it's going to be a lot more fun. But still, thanks for tuning in. This is going to be a good game, and it's been a while since I've been solo casting. But it's a different feel, right? It's a different feel. SF joining, a little bit dangerous, and actually they did buy up anyway, but it's just FAMASes and CSET 75 and one MAX 7 as well, which I'm a little bit disappointed the MAX 7 is here and not at the B-bomb site, but that's just a personal preference for me. I think right where SF is right here is much better with the MAX 7 than it is at the A-bomb site, but we'll see if Shoxi can make it work. Fnatic right now, as they've been doing for the past 5 rounds, taking it really slowly. But once they get the pickoffs, that's usually when they just run in and manage to secure the round. So, can't really blame them for what they've been up to. SF going for another flashbang. He's got to be really careful. If he goes down, that's definitely going to be the round. And they're all coming for him. Completely overrun. The opening happened when GMX went down on short. And then it was just an easy walk into the B-bomb site to take everyone else down there. Now, I would say definitely Kiyoshima should be saving this one. And Shoxi and FXJ, they can go for some pickups. If they can find a kill and pick up a rifle, it's going to be great. But other than that, Fnatic are looking quite strong on this map right now. See if there's going to be an adjustment eventually for Epsilon. Because so far, I think everyone has realized what the weakness is. It's the B-bomb site. If you haven't figured it out, it's definitely the B-bomb site. FXJ waiting over here, and you can hear a lot of people running right in front of him, and actually will take down Pronax, so good job. Can pick up the AK as well. That is sort of a small victory, but that's how they need to get back into this. We're into the 7th round, and I think if Fnatic can get 6 rounds, and they're sort of halfway there, if they can get up to 6 rounds, they're going to be in a good position. Otherwise, well, it could get a little bit tricky. And it's still going to be an eco. Are they going to be able to? SF? Alright, just very late to buying, which is really dangerous. Might work out for them this time, because it looks like it's going to be an A push, and they have exactly the setup to deal with this, except when they start walking down middle. I really want them to be inside the bomb site and not outside of this ring. If they're outside it, which actually they all are now, I think Fnatic are going to be able to throw some really easy smokes and just keep them on the outside. But Here it comes. Grenade rains over and Schneider... Oh, sorry, Olafmeister goes down. Schneider's no longer on the team, so... Luckily for him, he's not going to die, but... Kiyoshima way in the back here looking for the kill. Pronax taking a little bit of damage, and this is looking alright so far for Epsilon, but they gotta be careful they don't get flanked here. Flush, I can't really see much for the smoke, but if he gets the right timing, it might just work out. And it actually goes down to Superfighter, so not exactly the ideal flank coming out. Crim's very low on health, but there it is. Pronax and JW now fighting back, and let's see if they can actually get this bomb down. They've moved into the bomb site and just waiting on the edge, which is a very, very dangerous strat for Fnatic, but... Because Epsilon keep peeking them, it's working out somehow. Now it's a 2-on-3, and they've managed to somehow turn the tide. FXO is going to be walking up. He goes down. Crims actually pre-firing that corner. Nice play. And now SF alone and in an awful position. Epsilon throwing away around here that they absolutely had no cause to do so, but that is how it sort of works out at the end. Superfighter looking to see if he can clutch the 1-on-3, but I actually don't even really want him to. Fnatic have already done more than enough, and Crims will be the one to pick up a triple kill. So let's go through real quick what actually went wrong this round. What Fnatic did is usually a very, very bad thing. If you go for this A bomb site, you don't want to get stuck in these positions right here. You want to get the bomb down, and then you can fall back to these positions up in the hallways or anywhere you feel like. But you don't want to be stuck here before the bomb is down. And that's what Fnatic did, and the reason why it's bad is because you can get grenaded a lot, and the other team has time to rotate. And Epsilon did rotate. Unfortunately for Epsilon, they rotated in a way so that they actually just went and peeked one by one and got taken down. In the middle, FXO loses his life before shooting that AWP. Well, he fired it, but he didn't get any kills. So, didn't really work out for him. But there was a return from DMX, and I guess that's something. But right now, Epsilon are making some weird mistakes in terms of over-committing to some of these bomb sites. Olafmeister going to be walking right in, and Shoxy's there. We'll pick the headshot and then get time to fall back with 19 HP. And this is the point in time when Epsilon should decide to play it really safely, especially with SF over here. Yep, they can commit DMX to going to the A bomb site, so this is some good movement coming out from Epsilon. As long as they stay safe now, it's not impossible for them to lose the round, but it's going to be hard. They're going to have to try actively to throw this round away if they really want to. Alright, Kiyoshima. And... Shoxy's not in a position either that's very grenadable. Kind of hard to land a grenade right here. Be impressive if they manage to catch that. But we'll see if it's going to happen. 30 seconds left. SF is moving up. Now they're really sure. They absolutely know now it's going to be a push for the A bomb site. And Shoxy's just hiding in the back. Would want to get a little bit of backup here if he can. Yeah, Kiyoshima's now in a much better position. Going to spot out the one, and there it is. Now Flusher is going to go down as well. And that's a pretty cool position, just planking almost right by the ladder. That was Shoxy picking up a triple kill that round, nicely done here. And he's at 7-2-3. We're going to be at 4-4 for the scoreline, heading into the ninth round. And Fnatic have enough money to buy, including an AWP on JW, which is very cool to see. Again, they're leaving the bomb behind. Oh, GMX is going to be walking right in, and JW uses the sniper rifle as a shotgun and takes him down. Very nicely done. SF is going to fall next, and they just need to save now. Kiyoshima, FXO, and Shoxy just throwing rifles away at this point. Really no reason that they try and retake that bomb site at that point, because this isn't like... It isn't like the B bomb site on Dust2 or something else where you could easily get a pickoff on someone and maybe turn it into a... to a 3-on-4 or something like that. Almost 100% chance you're going to lose rifles. And the really bad thing is that Olafmeister's already out hunting, so there's a really big chance, I think, that Epsilon could be losing a lot of rifles right here. Misses the shot on JW, and Kiyoshima's now sort of trapped in the middle of everything. Flusher's going to take him down, and Shoxy, I think they even know where he is, because I think Olafmeister heard him. So he is also completely boxed in. Fnatic not just having a good time of taking these bomb sites, but they are... aggressively making sure that Epsilon won't save anything. Look at that. Flashbang down. It's like they... It's almost like they have Warhack, but that's just because they're so good at communicating and using their sounds. Really, really great five rounds here for Fnatic. Epsilon able to pick up just a one here on the... Once the rifles is in, they've only had one out of six rounds, and that is not a good trend for the CT side. Well, let's see how this all unfolds. GMX has a deagle in hand. Of course, this is an eco round from Epsilon, and it's actually quite bad. They will be able to buy an extra round, but it won't be the most impressive buy. If you have 2,000 and you know the upcoming round, they're going to have 3,500 on Shoxy. So It's just not a lot of money on his side here. And of course everyone else is a little bit higher, so they will be able to buy M4s, but Shoxi probably going to be left with, well, I guess it could be a Mach 7 like last time, or at least a FAMAS. Flash over the good opening. Crims picking up the second one. Good shot from FXO, but not sure it's... Oh, actually, he gets that second headshot. That was impressive. JW thought he could jump down behind the van quick enough. Shoxi's going to pick off Pronax. But in spite of all of this, the retake is a completely different matter. Bomb hasn't actually gone down yet. All of mice are still up here with it. So, a slight opening. And if Epsilon could win this round, it'd definitely be a huge turnaround for them. This is exactly the kind of round they need to win. But just taking rifles away from Fnatic is not enough here. Shoxi's been spotted already. Bomb is going to go down. Instant headshot. 5-7 is definitely a good choice, but he needs to get a little bit closer before he's in the headshot range. And they should be able to crossfire him even easily. I think this is going to be almost impossible for Kyushima. Doesn't have any smoke or any flashbang or anything else to zone out the bomb site with. He's just going to be walking in, and Crims will take him down. 6-4 is now the score that we're looking at, with Pronax top fragging, Crims nearby. Olafmeister, Flusher, and JW taking a bit of a vacation, but they can afford to do that because they're already two rounds ahead. FXO again going to be picking up the AWP, and we need him to step up and play like he played some of the other times we've seen him on Mirage, because otherwise Epsilon are going to have a very bad first half here. And FXO walking into the middle. They're going to be really close. Fnatic know exactly what's up, and he goes down without firing a shot. And this has been happening way too often. DMX goes down next. Epsilon, just their style is not working against Fnatic at all. Nothing seems to be working for them. SF going to come through, get a kill right here. But the two people over by the ramp, I'm not sure they're going to be surviving for very much longer. Flusher takes a kill on one. Shoxi's going to pick up one more, but he's on 8 HP. And Olafmeister is coming for him to take him down. Now a 1-on-3 for Superfighter, who seems to be alone almost all the time here. Once the round draws to an end. The bomb is going to be planted in a position where he can't even really stop it, so no luck for him. Brave move from Superfighter, but doesn't really happen for him at all. He's going to go down. And one of the key differences, I feel like, last time we saw FXO play, he got a lot of kills from the window, a lot of kills from down here by Connector, against people who were just standing up here, who were sort of ready to take a fight with him at range, but they never really did anything else. Fnatic, they've been grenading this spot, and they've been moving up close, and they've been doing a lot of things that some of the other teams weren't. So I don't know if they've been studying FXO, I'm not even sure they have, I just feel like they just have a style that's slightly more aggressive, and it punishes the risky plays that Epsilon are doing, because they are peeking a lot. They peek in the beginning, so they end up having, you know, being a man down, and then when they're a man down, they re-peek again, and then they're two people down. Fnatic's really good at just taking care of that. Crims with a good pickoff as well. Shoxi and FXO are going to be back alone against a 2-on-5 here. Not really the ideal situation. We will see. This is about to be 8-4 in the first half on the T side of Mirage. Things not looking too good right now for the Epsilon team. It's definitely not over. Four rounds is not enough on the CT side. We've seen comebacks from four rounds, but I'd say for a comeback to be not a completely godlike comeback, but just one that's, you know, remotely possible, they probably need to get themselves up to around six rounds. Some good pickoffs at the end, but that's still not enough here. Shox is going to pick off one more, so they only survive with Flusher. That's kind of good, but if you look at the money that's going on Fnatic's side, it isn't even a problem for them. They can easily be behind. Fnatic can... they can actually buy for the rest of this game. It doesn't even matter. Epsilon just needs to try and see if they can make this 8-7. If they can, they still have a fair chance of winning this, no doubt about that. But if they lose any more rounds, I'm starting to doubt that it'll really happen. Superfighter down here. Grenade should be perfectly timed right about now, but he's still hesitating. There it is. Kiyoshima's going to pick off a kill on Olafmeister, and now the question is, can GMX and SF defend this bombsite? Previously, they haven't been able to. A lot of times on the road, they've lost this, and that smoke was definitely not how it was intended. DMX going to take down Pronax, and they spot another person. And now Epsilon just have to play safe. J Just like that. Allow Crims to peek instead of the other way around. Although, I don't know if you guys noticed, but it looked for a minute like SF was going to try and peek as well. And he has no reason to do that. Really important stuff that they don't peek in a 5-on-3. It's just not worth it. Flusher and JW now shouldn't really have a chance of winning this, but again, there is no reason to do this. There's so much money in Fnatic, they'll never force them to eco anyway. And at worst, they're going to lose a 2-on-5, which would be horrendous. In the middle, FXJO goes down. Now it's a 2-on-3, and Fnatic can win it. Whereas previously, it was almost impossible, I would say. Shoxy's waiting over here, and this is a more smart play. JW's going to be running with the knife out, and he should be going down pretty easily. Walking around the corner, still picks up the kill. And Epsilon, I mean, this is definitely one for the history books. Now, Kiyoshima waiting here. He just has to deny the plan once, and they won't be able to win the round, but they're in the wrong position for it. 6 seconds left. There is going to be a bomb plant now. GMX alone. He gets the one kill, but JW is still alive. He's already got the triple. Looking to see if he can pick up a rifle. He's going to jump up on the box. Misses the shot. Now, grenade comes out, but GMX is too close, and I'm not sure JW realizes he's going to flash out once, and he should be going down. There it is. GMX takes him down, but what an incredibly expensive round for Epsilon. This should be a huge lesson. It's basically being carved out in stone now, what has been losing Epsilon rounds. And if the French team don't realize themselves by now, well, then I'm not sure what we can do to help them. They just turned a 5-on-2 into a 1-on-1. Not because Fnatic did anything exceptionally cool, you know, not some sort of miraculous play. Just waiting patiently, which is still smart play, but waiting patiently and allowing the French team to feed themselves one at a time, and they did it happily. Now let's see, is it going to be a push towards this B bomb side? It's sort of shaping up to be one. GMX and Superfighter and FXJO making the rotation, so seems like this time Epsilon have the right read. Question is if they're going to be able to pick up the first kills. Shoxy looking down towards underpass, but actually it's up in the whorehouse, as we call it, that Crims and Flusher have taken up root, and it's going to be a really powerful B rush. Once it happens, they're going to come two people through apartments and two people in through catwalk, and they're going to be at the bomb site almost instantaneously. So if SF and GMX go down, if any of them die here, then it's going to be really tricky, especially when FXJO is running away like this. Shoxy might be making the right call going up the middle here, but look at how patient. This is Fnatic actually playing almost like Na'Vi would normally do it. It's really cool to see, and I think we pointed this out last time as well. Na'Vi's one of the only other teams that plays this slowly. Nice shot from Shoxy, going to take down Olofmeister. Definitely worth it, but it's not enough. They need to hold us on this bomb site. That's the key thing right now. GMX in a pretty good position, maybe looking for a kill here, but he won't get it. He's going to go down, and now the game is up pretty much. Flusher will go down to Shoxy, but Shoxy needs to do a lot more. This is still a 3-on-3, even though Pronax is kind of low. They need to see if they can retake this. Shoxy goes down. Nice headshot from Crims, and Kiyoshima and FXJO, they have to try and retake this. Now it's too late. They can't afford Fnatic to get up to 9 rounds. Grenade rains in, doesn't do anything at all, and they've wasted too much time already. Don't see them retaking this. Fnatic are a scary beast right now. Kiyoshima with a good kill. FXJO running in 1-on-2 with just an AWP at such a close range. Still picks up the one kill, now running. See if he can take down Pronax, and what? He misses all the shots, and Pronax had 25 HP to start with, still survives. And it's going to be 15 rounds in. 9-5 here is what we're looking at. And Fnatic off to a really, really good start. Now let's just see. One sec. Just got to quickly take care of something. All right. 9-5. First half score. Sorry about that, guys. Just had to quickly sort something out in the Twitch chat and it'll be all right. And obviously, we're at the 15th round here. Epsilon reduced to 1 for Mars, 1 Max, 7 and a Deagle. And this is going to be a 10-5 first half. JW making minced meat of SF, who was playing a dangerous game like they've been doing all game. There's one key word that is just plaguing Epsilon right now. And it is just overpeaking. Too much aggression. FXJO going to take down Olofmeister, but they lose the A-bomb site. And the final round of the half. Kiyoshima and GMX really can't be expected to win this at all. They don't have a kit. They have a decoy grenade, which is kind of fun, but not really the sort of equipment they're looking for to try and win this. Not even going to be a 1D. Crims ends up with a double kill. Good half is called, and it's 10-5 for the first half, and Epsilon in a very strange position, I would say. Alright, that is the first half of this match. If you're just joining us, then welcome to the stream. This is Room on Fire, and we're watching the SLTV Starseries Season 10. I'm Anders, and with me is nobody. I'm going to be solo casting this first game, but Hiko from Complexity should be joining us right afterwards. So I want to thank all of you for tuning in. I really appreciate you guys hanging out with me. It's always a bit strange solo casting, especially when you haven't been doing it for a while, but I'm still glad you guys want to come hang out with me, because this is a fun game. And remember, we have a goal for the evening, guys. It's a collective goal here for everyone in the chat, so you guys will join me in it, and it is the idea of getting Hiko up to 10,000 followers. We started at 9,100, now he's at 9,300, so we're getting there. He's not even on. If we can get him to 10,000 before he even comes on, how cool would that be? He's 700 short, guys, so click his Twitter link right there and go and follow him, because he's such a great guy, and we want to try and repay him something back here. So it's pretty easy stuff. Just a small click, and we'll be able to repay him in a way that we otherwise can't. So, you know, he does it for free, just comes out and hang out with us, and we really do appreciate it. Now, the second half is going to be coming up, and let's see if Fnatic are able to follow this one through. They have a great lead. They haven't won the game yet, and let's see if Epsilon are going to be playing smarter on the terrorist side. They're running up the middle here. Crims not really exposing himself too much, just listening to a lot of people coming in. It's going to be a great A push coming out. Smokes everywhere. This is nicely executed from Epsilon so far. Olaf Meister way in the back here, running out of bullets, but just has one left for SF, and still one in the chamber if there was going to be another one. So very nicely played. GMX will take down Pronax, and now the bomb is down. Flusher having a fight over at the whorehouse. JW jumps up here. FXJ will take a headshot. Kiyoshima with the second one. Now it's down to JW and Flusher. 2-on-3, and Epsilon again. All they have to do is play safe. They don't need to challenge. Just wait for Fnatic to come, and it's going to be all right. There's JW taking down one, and again, they just go hyper-aggressive and lose the round. This is an absolute tragedy coming out from Epsilon. They do it on the CT side, they do it on the terrorist side. Just keep rushing in when there's no call to. Alright, the bomb is down right here, the optimal position. They have a guy here, they had one guy over here, and I'm not sure if they didn't have a second guy over here. So there is no way Fnatic can retake this, none at all. All they have to do is wait. If Fnatic try and defuse it, they are coming in from three different angles. And instead, what they decide to do is run into the middle of the bomb site and take a fight, and then just lose all their momentum and all their advantage. Completely mind-blowing what's happening here. Right. Crims taking an easy kill in the middle, and this should be no contest. What we're looking at is for Fnatic to make this basically 13-5 before Epsilon can really start buying here. And at that point, you have to wonder if it isn't going to be too late, basically. Counter-terrorists win. Well, there's the 12-5. And oh, I miscalculated, guys. I'm sorry. They did put the bomb down. So they do have the money to buy in this round. I forgot about that. I was so busy worrying about Epsilon's aggression that I completely miscalculated. But yep, they do have AKs and three grenades, which is enough to execute for any bombsite, but they obviously need to actually do it. And now Fnatic going very aggressive here, but they can definitely afford to do it. They have the money and they have the rounds to get it happening. JW will pick down a kill. Crims with another one here looking for Kiyoshima. And that is going to be it. The only kill that Epsilon get this round is from Superfighter, who takes down Crims. 13-5, and Epsilon back to ecoing. And things just looking overwhelmingly positive here for the Swedish team. And this is good news. We are just... how long away? I can't do maths. What date is it today? Oh my god, I should have checked this before I started that sentence. It's the 25th, and on the 2nd and 3rd, we have the Gfinity, the G3D coming up. So we are just, well, a little bit more than a week away from that tournament, and that is going to be a really important one. That's right before the Gamescom tournament that ESL is hosting, so everything is on the line right now. And for Fnatic to look this much on point, I think is a really, really good start. I imagine they'll be a top contender for both tournaments, actually. We'll see if it's going to stay like this throughout the evening. Epsilon, what's really tragic, what's really annoying about watching them play right now is that the mistakes they're making are mistakes that are really easy to fix. That one, that 2-on-5 that they almost threw away, it's not like, you know, all they had to do was stand still. If they just unbound their, you know, their W key, they'd be all right. They'd be in a better position. Just stand still with your rifle in one place and they could have won a lot of those rounds in the first half, but it just doesn't happen. Now, aggressive move coming up from Fnatic. Krim's moving up right here, going to take down FXGO, and Flush is there to back him up. So right now it's just going to be an equal trade, and Flusher will make sure it's uneven. Equalized quickly by SF, and he was up in the middle here, but they got to be careful. Once that smoke clears, JW, he is poised to take this shot. He's got the AWP, he's crouching, he's waiting for it, and it's just a matter of time. Actually, they're going to re-smoke it, and JW, pretty little bit upset. He was just counting the minutes or the seconds till it was gone. He's still going to pick up a kill, and now Pronax coming up from behind takes down SF. Fnatic have such a good read on what's happening in this game. Kiyoshima takes down one, and still in a 1-on-2 here. He realizes Pronax was somewhere there. Good shot through the wall, but he needs a lot more. Olafmeister's low on health. Maybe Kiyoshima could clutch this, but if he walks all the way over, is Olafmeister going to take care of him? Pronax looking the wrong angle, and this is a really good one. He's reloading and walking forward, and Pronax takes him down. And Kiyoshima also reloading with 27 bullets left. I just don't know what's happening anymore. 15-5. And Epsilon looking, I don't know, like a different team from the one we saw a couple of days ago. Let's just see. We're into the 21st round, where Fnatic have a 10-round lead against the French team. And already, Krim's going to be picking off FXGO, who was running up the middle with a grenade out. They're just making, I don't know, nothing but mistakes right now, unfortunately. But I guess everyone is allowed to have a bad day, and Epsilon definitely not one of their best days. They beat Hellraisers, you know, just in our Case King tournament a couple of days ago, so they definitely have a lot to show us, but this was not something they were ready for. Fnatic just way too strong at the moment. 16-5 as a scoreline, and that is it. The first game is over. How long did that take? That took, what, 30 minutes? That's half an hour for one game. Unbelievable. Well, our next game coming up, guys, is going to be virtus.pro versus Fnatic. That is also a best-of-one game. Hope you guys are ready for it. And maybe Fnatic, looking a little bit strong, might persuade some people to bet their skins differently. Either way, I'm going to try and see if I can get Hiko on fast enough. I think I should be able to. And then we're going to have a good time. So Hiko will be joining us. Remember, go and follow Hiko on Twitter. We want to see if we can get up to 10,000 viewers. And he's about 10,000 followers, sorry, on Twitter. He's about 700 short. So go and follow him. And I'll bring him on in just a second. For now, we'll listen to a little music, and then we'll be right back.